So to fit the sides of the centre plate case, they're already cut roughly to shape and size. And the screw holes we drilled through the hog and the keel before we started planking. When we put the ribs in, they went right across the bottom of the boat. We've marked them and trimmed them off. So hopefully these now sit down against these end ledges. And all we need to do is to run a pencil up fore and aft, cut these off, plane the edges a bit, make sure they sit down flush on the keel, on the hog, and then we're ready to fasten them in. The insides of the centre plate case have had two coats of sealer, and before we assemble it, we'll give them a coat of underwater primer as well, just to protect them throughout their life. We've got the centre thwart lifted up out the way. So that's looking pretty good. All we need to do now is to mark where we want to cut. There and there. Our seat has got to drop down onto the stringer, obviously. And at the moment, these have been left tall. So we just want to make sure that we've got enough there to plane off, and we know roughly what we're taking off. So the seat's got to come down just over 4¾ inches. So if we come down here 4¾ inches, gives us a good guide to where we've got to be. And while the boat's still sat straight and level, we can mark that off there. That's out. The other thing we want to do we'll take one side of the centre plate case away. We've got a plywood template for the centre plate, is to just mark where this front ledge has got to be trimmed, because the arm of the centre plate comes up over it, and so I want to cut that off beforehand rather than trying to get through it when we've got the sides of the centre plate case on. This is our centre plate, which is going to sit in there somewhere. and pivot around the bolt through there. So that's where the front of the centre plate sticks through. So we're looking at trimming that off there. And when the centre plate is lowered, this arm's sticking up here. So I think that should be okay for that. That'll be one job that's a lot easier to do now than when the sides are on. Doing now is just making sure the bottoms are level, flush with each other. Just clamping the two sides together so we can trim up the ends so they're a matching pair. In this way, we just want to make sure we don't split the end away. That's the top, and we've got about 3/4 of an inch of waste timber there. May just help us to stop the edge splitting away. So that's that. All we need to do is just make sure the bottoms are clean where the sealer was done on the inside. There's a few dribbles on the what's going to be the bottom. So we just want to mark this off because it'll be a lot easier cutting it now. And when the sides are on. Thank you.
And I want to move the boat that way a little bit, if you just keep her balanced there. And do the same back here. So I can get to the slot, really, is the aim of the game. That's it. Legs on, so I shouldn't fall over. So what we're doing is lowering the middle seat down onto some inch blocks at each end, and I've got an equally sized block there. So now I can scribe the top of the centreplate case exactly where we want it to be for the seat to drop straight onto it. There are two things to check. One is that centreplate case sides are down on the hog, and the other is that you're not leaning on the seat when you scribe it, because that can lead to what we call inaccuracies. That's down. Seat is down on its block to each side, so with that held there, like that. I've drilled the pilot holes up through the keel. So we're ready to take everything out, trim that up, a final coat of primer inside, and then put it all together while it's wet.